confidence on Saturday in Providence. Time now to take a look at the starting lineups. I'm Gus Johnson along with Coach Bill Raftery. We know about the great point guard matchup between Zegarowski and Gillespie. Who else jumps out at you, Coach?
Christian Bishop, he's active, he's athletic, passes well, slips well. Karen Edwards, Jeremiah Robinson Earl, big time factor in his rebounding, low post play, and his ability to make the deep shot.
All right, the coach is Greg McDermott. Terrific coach, wonderful man, got himself in some hot water this week. We'll talk about that later. He's 56 years old. On the other sideline, Jay Wright, two-time national champion, 59 years old. He's worried about the way his team is defending, and Coach Raff will get deep into that as this game progresses.
And of course, all about pace this game. Talking to both coaches, Villanova will opportunistically break, but basically control the tempo, and of course the woo-woo ability of Creighton.
Coach, I'm waiting. Where's the man-to-man?
I am. Right now, Creighton, Johnson goes a little man-to-man.
All right, now we're off to a great start and an early turnover. Here comes Zegarowski the other way. What a wonderful player. Marcus Zegarowski, the preseason Big East Player of the Year.
Creighton. And he is back. He's back, Gus. He's playing great right now. Feeling good.
Bishop inside the kick. Mahoney. And he hits his first shot. That's a great sign for the Blue Jays.
Boy, inside out. And you got to contend with the push and the early threes. Got to get back, peel off, and match up deep.
Creighton beat Villanova 86-70 2 weeks ago in Omaha. Marcus Zegarowski scored a season-high 25, and Mitch Ballack had 17 of his 20 in the second half. Blue Jays pulled away from the Wildcats, shooting 59%.
Got a dribble drive, jump stop in the lane, pump fake. You got to stay on the ground.
And Gillespie turns it over. Rare occasion for Villanova, one of the best teams at protecting the basketball in college basketball.
You dodge one in that early offense when they get these clean looks.
That ball really moves. Damian Jefferson to the hole with the gliding finger roll, and it goes down.
Well, they are so good. You close out, don't have the weight properly distributed. A little bit of a blow ball, but Pollock, goodness, he can make so many shots. He's so unselfish. Passes up a lot of good opportunities.
Both these teams coming off losses. Villanova lost to Butler 73-61 Sunday at Hinkle. And the only stat you need to know in that game is 2 for 27. That's what Nova was from beyond the arc. Robinson Earl. Loose ball. Daniels with the rebound. New shot clock. The two-lane transfer. And a whistle and foul. Ballack fouling Samuels.
That's the big thing with Villanova. You can't give them second opportunities. Obviously, a lot of threes are cast. Those long rebounds favor the offensive team.
Creighton lost to Xavier 77-69 Saturday at Cintas. Paul Scruggs for Xavier. At a game-high 23 points. And that one goes down. Villanova on the board.
You got to take good shots if you're Villanova. Zegarowski really keeps the dribble alive and finds people.
Samuels with the rebound. He'll rake it and take it into the front court. Daniels, you feel like he's still trying to find his way on this Villanova team, Coach, even though he's starting.
Yeah, I'd like to see him drive a little bit more, get in the lane and distribute on occasion. Nice clean look.
Justin Moore really developing in his sophomore season at Villanova. He's coming off a 10-point game in 33 minutes on Sunday against Butler.
He's got a power game too, Moore. Can really get in that lane, take advantage, size and bulk.
Colin Gillespie, this kid is the man, folks. Tough, tough hombre. Moore, hesitation, baseline, damage. And a rebound to Bishop.
You're really talking about two great point guards in Zegarowski. He does that little change of pace and gets to the rim. A little lingerie on the deck and a couple of cats.
Marcus Zegarowski on the Naismith wooden and koozie point guard watch list for the number one point guard in America. Had knee surgery last year. They say he's starting to finally, Coach Raff, get his lift back.
Greg says he's at top of his game right now. He's really been solid of late.
Gillespie knocks down a triple.
Well, you got to get up on him, too. Feeling pretty good. That sets up his dribble drive game.
Colin Gillespie, 14 points in his last game. Here comes Villanova off the turnover. And more to the basket. And he'll punch it down with the right hand.
And what a nice look, too. Earl delivers on the money.
10-7, Nova. Villanova's won two of their last three, four of their last six. Wiborowski.
They love these dribble exchanges and a slip to the tin, usually by Bishop.
And a timeout on the floor. Villanova off to a good start on top of Creighton, 10-7. Confidential, as this is a personal matter. And we spoke to Coach Mack via Zoom this morning. Coach Rath, he was contrite of heart. He felt bad not only for himself and what he said, but he also felt bad for his players and the hurt that he saw on their faces when those words came out of his mouth. I've known Coach McDermott for a decade. He's a good man, salt of the earth man, and I believe him when he says that he is totally sorry for those comments.
Yeah, I guess he was heartsick and disappointed himself for the pain he may have caused. He feels for his players and broke down the trust he felt ever since they started recruiting. We all know this is a decent and highly respected man. He misspoke. He's sorrowful. I hope the trust that this team and he have, they can bond together and rectify their, have faith and belief in one another and get it going again.
Damian Jefferson off the mark. That ball out of bounds, but will stay right here. Last touched by Nova. All five Creighton starters this season, folks, averaging between 10.5 and 15 points a game and account for 78% of the team's scoring. So Coach McDermott has developed a system over the years at Creighton in 11 seasons where the ball, Coach Raftery, moves so fast.
Doesn't
These guys
stick.
Look so unselfish.
You wouldn't be able to play, Gus, with your dribble drive and your spins and whatever. But, yeah, they are unselfish. It just doesn't stay in one spot. Goes side to side. They run some really nice stuff, some ball screens, some doubles.
Zagorowski deep off the heel. Rebounded by Robinson Earl.
He is a big-time rebounder, that kid.
Now here's the post game. By Gillespie.
Got to stay at home. Contain your own.
15 to shoot. Robinson Earl guarded by Bishop. That'll be a great matchup. Samuels fouled by Zagorowski on the switch.
And Bishop out on the floor there. I'd like to see them attack him a little bit. And Villanova, they know how valuable this kid is to that team.
Ballack will leave the game, and Sharif Mitchell replaces him. He's a sophomore from Omaha. Sunrise Christian in Kansas.
Well, he can get after people, can really rag a guy.
Gillespie turning the corner, cut off, skip pass. Moore. Samuels got the puppies organized, Coach Ryan.
What a ball movement there, reminiscent of Creighton.
You don't mind if I use your stuff, do you, Coach?
No,
you don't mind if I use your stuff.
Absolutely not. Just give me some of your commercials. I really do have to.
I don't know about that. I don't know about that, Coach.
Here, let's not go too far.
Hey, here's Mahoney from long distance.
Man, this is the control of the game that Jay and his team does so well. Can run some clock down using yet a good opportunity.
Villanova starting this game 6 of 8. Nova on a 15-2 run since trailing 5-0. Nova has more threes today than in the Butler game the other day.
Man, nobody attacking the glass. Everybody back. Bounce on the floor. Can't give an inch.
Zagorowski. Baseline. Jefferson. Got it up. No. When we talked to Jay yesterday, Coach Rath, the thing he was the most concerned about was figuring a way to set his defense.
Absolutely. Very annoyed with the way they played the last few games. Not getting back, not controlling the opposition.
And Jay is such a modest man, nicest guy in the world. But yesterday, he had no time for us, Coach. He was like, man, I got to do stuff. What do you want?
I thought it was you.
It was.
You know what I'm saying? You little floater. You don't have that, you can't play as a guard. Once again, this is how they seize control of the game. Take away your energy a little bit.
Samuels facing on senior night. Robinson Earl.
Once again, everybody back.
In and out dribble. Zegarowski looked like he traveled. Out of bounds. We'll stay right here.
Ooh. That was a pretty good look at the rim. It looked like Kyrie Irving-ish. Creighton really having some problems the last 4.5 minutes. Not being able to score. This is pretty impressive.
He hit a reverse layup like that in the first Villanova Creighton game in Omaha. That was spectacular.
Thought he could have had it on the same side that way.
We'll take a seat.
Can run a team, can score. Prototype combo.
Alex O'Connell has checked in, number 5 for Creighton. Replacing Zegarowski.
Slater on the floor, too. Match up with Kalkbrenner. That's the one thing about Villanova. They're not an impactful team around the rim. Solid, basic defense.
Kalkbrenner, a big fella. He's a 7-footer.
Good footwork.
And a whistle and foul coming up. Looks like this will go against Slater as he ran into Sharif Mitchell.
A little drive. This is attack mode. We talked about his defense. O'Connell, of course, the Duke transfer.
Looks like that foul will be on Justin Moore instead.
Swider on the floor. They took advantage of him a little in his post defense. Now he's matched up on a guard.
O'Connell take.
Really makes you stretch out on the floor, gives so many opportunities to get to the lane.
Who right now, coach, does this pace favor? You would think Villanova.
Yeah, they've stolen 9 minutes of the game already.
Slater, nice move to the bucket and lays it in with the left hand.
Well, he's getting more and more minutes, playing with a lot of confidence.
Great looks flat to start this game. Antoine Jones, the Memphis transfer in for the Blue Jays. Kalkbrenner and fouled. He'll go to the line.
Time out. Got to take away the left on the bounce. Slater taking advantage of a little pump fake. Trademark of Villanova. I'm more worried about you coming back to New York.
I haven't been back in a year. Coach Rapp, I haven't been back in a year. I can't wait for Monday when I get into the Big Apple. Kalkbrenner at the free throw line. 7-footer on the season, a 61% free throw shooter, had 9 against Xavier in their loss on Saturday. 4 rebounds, a couple of blocks in 16 minutes.
Very fundamental kid, can do a lot of things, spin to a hook, good footwork, can block shots, big upside, pretty young guy.
From St. Louis, Missouri, 17-7, Nova. Pick and roll inside. They look and Kalkbrenner steals it. Nice anticipation.
They had to throw that in wider on the baseline. This is what you were talking about. They go side to side, screen, slip, rescreen, repost, pin down.
Sharif Mitchell.
Balak is just amazing. He gives bumps that provides opportunities to others.
7-point lead for the Wildcats. Gillespie slow offensively to start this game. Letting it come to him. Deep. High arcer rims off. O'Connell with the tough rebound keeps it inbounds. Now Jones.
All good again, the foot in that lane. O'Connell settles deep.
10 minutes to go, first half. Pace favoring Villanova. Slowed it down.
Look at that open middle, Gus. A lot of guys can drive. A little nickel dimer on the baseline on Mitchell. They just have a nice feel and flow. We've always talked about Greg McDermott's offensive mind. And always for the team, but like just a little nuisance screen gives an opportunity for a clean look and a little nylon as well.
However, Creighton 4 of 16 from the field, 25%. Villanova shooting 54% at 7 of 13. Inside Samuels. Leans in and a whistle and foul on the floor. That'll go against Antoine Jones.
Well, they are not biting on that pump fake, though. Did a good job in the game. Last game against Villanova, very sound thus far early.
Antoine Jones transferred from Memphis, and you'd like this coach. His nickname is Twando Rondo.
He's got a big upside, this kid. Good size. Gives him a lot of depth at that guard position.
6'6". Justin Moore driving, spinning. Oh, strong.
That's his game. Get to that box area.
19-10, Nova.
Great balance each trip. Nothing early for Creighton.
Right now they're sitting on Zegarowski and a steal. Slater got his hands on it. Moore the trailer. Slater to the hole with the right hand.
How about that?
And it's Slater gets Villanova a 21-10 lead. Ballock. That's a brick.
Seldom will you say that about him. He had a great stroke. They also have that jump shot play where they fake it.
Nova turns it over. Zegarowski the other way. Stop and start. Baseline pull up and good.
Boy, he does a nice job discarding in a legal fashion. Great footwork, great control of his weight on the pull-up.
Marcus Zegarowski coming off his second double-double of the year against Xavier on Saturday. He had 10 rebounds to go along with his 15 points. Mahoney back in the game.
And that's the guy to me. He's got to do some damage for this team. And he and Jefferson, so important to the cause.
Villanova, 8 assists on 9 made field goals, shooting 60% now.
And when they control the game, Gus, at their tempo, a leisurely pace, once in a while bites you.
Justin Moore.
Good passing team right to the pocket.
Ballock with the board.
Everybody back.
Force that one up. Can't get his own rebound. Wildcats the other way. Catch and shoot. Daniels. Short.
Well, I'm impressed with Villanova's defense. Getting back on a slap back. Controlling tempo.
Moving first half, Justin Moore drains a deep one. Nova clicking on all cylinders.
Making shots, puts a little hop in your step.
Ballock, good.
Give him an inch, he'll drill you.
Mitch Ballock averaging close to 11 per game. About the way his team is playing at home, especially considering how they fared against Creighton the first time 2 weeks ago, losing 86-70.
That's a different outlook today. Really solid defensively, not giving up easy looks, getting them on the timeline.
Justin Moore off to a very good start. He's got 10. And another jump shot goes down for Villanova.
How about that? He starts playing, bringing him a talented kid out of high school, Antoine. Big upside. He's had a bad shoulder for a couple of years, Gus. Trying to get deeper come tournament time.
6'5", out of Tinton Falls, New Jersey. He's played in 4 games after a long, difficult recovery from shoulder surgery.
Jay was so impressed with his attitude through all those difficult times, not being prepared health-wise to play.
Mahoney skips Jefferson. And back down. Gillespie inside. Forced it up. Well defended by Gillespie. And Gillespie goes down.
He may have gotten a foul by...
Oh, this kid. one of the toughest kids you'll ever see in college basketball.
That family, his followers, that kid in this program.
Demir Cosby Roundtree in attendance, not with the team this year, but here for senior night. He's also being celebrated. Inside, nice slip, Robinson Earl. 29-15. Coaches, Villanova changed their defense from the last time they played Creighton. From what you see. I'm sorry, we have lost Coach Raftery for a moment. So here's Mahoney. Crosses over, drives, cut off, forced up a bad shot. Loose ball, and it's rebounded by Slater. 29-15, 5:48 to play here in the first half. Backdoor, nice. Samuels, and a punch it. And now Greg McDermott's going to have to call timeout. His team asleep at the wheel. All Nova, all the time. Oh, no, Coach, I always love being with you.
Nice little step and go. That's that spread. You deny. Nice little back cut and nice pass to acknowledge as well.
Villanova shooting a blistering 62% from the field, 13 of 21.
There you go, nice slip. Bishop Quinn controlling it. It was from that little drop step counter he has.
Antoine remaining in the game for Nova. Daniels, the two-lane transfer. Samuels straight away, short. And a whistle and offensive foul against Denzel Mahoney.
Well, that was tough, though, I thought. I'm not so sure he was there. But they were so well coached to be in position. Well, he extended that arm, Gus. Blocked out a little bit, but
Denzel Mahoney,
coach, just have to fall.
Coach, Denzel Mahoney has his David Ruffin glasses on. You're probably one of the few people that know who that is listening to this telecast.
He's been wearing it for years.
Yes, he has.
He is a strong driver, pull up, cuts well. When he is making shots, it expands.
David Ruffin, the legendary singer from The Temptations. Samuels, rejected by Bishop. He steps back in bounds and misses a baseline J. Creighton answering, though.
I guess that's the first time the push and nobody acknowledging it's out and plays the shooter.
Gregorowski with seven. Half-court game so far. Favoring Nova. Daniels. Got it.
Around the horn. Pretty simple. Keep making those. You can do the blow-by. Unselfish two-hand chest pass right at the right spot.
Daniel sat out last season after transferring from Tulane. He averaged 17 points during the 2018-19 season.
He's one of those guards that can put some power in the box area, too. Attacking Swider here a little bit.
Zagorowski guarded by the bigger Samuels. Door, Mitchell, double pump,
cut.
No, but Cockbrenner is there for the foul.
In the right spot, nice cut by Mitchell. High and low action here, got to stay at home.
Samuels.
Break it down. Turn face challenge.
4 points against Butler on Sunday, and that snapped a streak of five straight games at double figures for Jermaine Samuels. Remember, he had 32 against Georgetown this year.
Mm-hmm. And across both these teams, the individual skills, how they improved during the course of the year.
Villanova, as Jeremiah Robinson Earl lays that one in, 14 assists on 16 hoops. Nova has four players with multiple.
be fun in New York when they all get together.
Jay Wright, though, must be concerned. His point guard, his leader, his captain, his senior, Colin Gillespie, has gone into the locker room after falling down hard. He grabbed one of his legs. We do not have an update. Folks, we are not at the game. I'm in Los Angeles. Coach Raftery is in New Jersey. The game is being played outside of Philly at Villanova. So we will get you the information on Gillespie as soon as we know something.
They go a little bit of zone look.
Cockburner with the layup.
That's where they have their problems, on that glass. Big fella active around the rim.
And I think, Coach, they do miss Villanova, Demir Cosby Roundtree.
Big time, Gus. Nobody says much about that. You know, he follows, tips, guards, rebounds, blocks. And that's where they have some limitations. Size.
A rim protector, Cosby Roundtree. He had surgery on his left leg, has not played this season. There he is in attendance tonight on senior night. Good young man.
He was hurt last year, Gus. You know, on and off. A little bit of opportunity to come back. Be interested to see if he does.
2:12 to play in the first half. All Villanova here. Patient, methodical, disciplined. Robinson Earl. Tariq Mitchell flying the other way.
So much more confident on the catch and shoot, though.
Fast break. Robinson Earl, quick release. Daniels, no. Caught Brenner with a rebound and a foul.
Interesting. I'm not sure they made it. Maybe hit the shot clock above the rim.
So they'll put 1:44 on the clock, 28 on the shot clock.
I guess you want to make a donation of Villanova.
Donation? Coach. Whoa. You know, my nickname is Alligator Man. I can't get my hands in my pockets that deep. Mitchell.
They do a great job using their bigs to screen.
Mitchell across the lane, stops. Cockburner just forced it up, strong.
Well, Mitchell can really put the brakes on and turn around and make that spin jumper. Didn't get away with it that time.
Daniels wraps it around. Swider thought about it. Ballet closed on him quickly.
If I could shoot like that, kids, that would have been up.
You could shoot like that, kid, Coach.
Oh, no, this kid's got range and touch.
Daniels flat, short. Nice rebound inside. Slater as he pulled it down with one hand and whipped back up quickly to get it to fall.
Big-time snatch. Got right to the rim, good anticipation. But you get those follows when you have good shooters, which both of these teams do. Very typical misses.
40-22, Nova. Putting on a clinic here in the first half against their rivals, the Creighton Blue Jays. Cockburner guarded by Daniels. He's got a height advantage. Leans in and draws contact.
Take advantage of those mismatches. Both clubs are so good at that. They read their defender, get the ball to the right spot, but this is what you enjoy. Look at that. One arm, the ability to dominate. Daniels with his second foul.
Brandon Slater.
Gillespie out. Sorry, Gus. You got Gillespie out, and you got Daniels and Moore with two, Gus.
Something to pay attention to. Cockburner at the line. Not the first consensus top 100 recruit, Ryan Cockburner. He wears a size 18. Big fella.
He's not Bob Lanier, though.
What'd he wear, 21?
I thought it was 22, but you might be right.
40-23.
There's a family in his shoes.
Like Shaq, Coach. Inside, nice move. Robinson Earl with the around-the-world fake, and he goes up and in.
I love this kid.
And that's the end of the first half. What a first half for Nova. Talking about the team that was ready to play at the start of this game. Nova up 42-23.
Payback. The impact this has on a whole family. And God willing, hopefully he's...
This kid
gonna
is
gonna bounce back. Yeah, he's tough.
He's the toughest you'll ever see.
Yeah, exactly.
No tattoos, no beard, no crazy hair, but the toughest man on the floor, night in and night out.
Well said. Let's see if Creighton can get it going a little. Bishop, no fouls. Wasn't a factor at all. He's got to get busy, I think. There's that little mismatch. Nice front.
Creighton hasn't lost a game by more than eight this year, so they got a run in them. This team leads the Big East in shooting despite that 29% first half you just saw.
Now they are an offensive machine. They can get it up there quickly. Put some numbers on the board.
Nova has not shot a free throw today, which may say more about how Creighton is not defended at the rim. Well, a jump shot goes down. It's a great sign.
Beautiful set on the out of bounds. A little double screen and then a read screen. Get those puppies organized. Number 24. Show a little life here.
Ballack with six. 42-26. Baseline Samuels. Contested by Damian Jefferson. There's a man that really needs to get going for Creighton. Damian Jefferson. He had 19 Absolutely. In their last game. Ballack again, no.
Easy. Too easy. Little drop step. Nobody at home defensively.
Justin Moore. Continuing to play solid basketball. He has 12 points. He's 5 for 5 from the field. Bishop stolen away. Villanova hits the deck. Scoops it up.
They are playing really tough defense. Rallying to the ball. Deflections.
Robinson Earl. Squares. Air ball. Jefferson straight to the basket and lays it in. Nobody picked him up.
Absolutely. That's where they're so effective. They push the ball, get themselves organized in the early dribble drive. If they shut you down, a little kick three. Looks like a little 1-3-1 zone. Corner jumpers and rebound. Nice dive to the rim.
A great pass by Jermaine Samuels to Brandon Slater to give Villanova a 46-28 lead. Zagorowski's been quiet. They put a taller, bigger defender on him in this game.
Villanova automatic switches, so there's a lot of mismatch opportunities.
And Daniels foul going to the rim.
Nice to see guys taking over a little with the dribble drive. Something Gillespie contributes. But down the other end, just a nice opportunity. Foul line dive, as you mentioned, terrific. Look, Samuels does so many nice things for this basketball team. And we're not accustomed to playing a lot of zone or 1-3-1 zone. There's going to be breakdowns.
Daniels with two free throws, a rare instant impact transfer at Nova. Even Eric Pascal, was mostly on the bench his first year.
He's not on the bench, he's making a nice living right now, right?
Yes, he is, the Golden State Warrior. No energy from Creighton tonight.
No, not at all. Villanova doing a great job inside like this. That's their 28th point. And really not with post-ups. Dives, dribble drives.
Zagorowski underneath. Jefferson sets.
Nice kick out by Bishop.
Damian Jefferson. 4-3 with 7.
Because when you're an uptick team like Creighton is, and the pulse is taken away from you, it's really difficult to get energized. You're going to reach inside a little bit here, get some good defensive stops, and get it out.
What is that? Villanova jump stop, more ball fake inside.
You saw it all there. That's their clinic.
Mahoney lost it, taken away. Another turnover for Creighton.
Boy, they are really missing a beat, Creighton. And Villanova really solid.
Bishop, Zagorowski, Bishop, Mahoney, Jefferson, Ballock, inside, nice play, Jefferson.
Pretty, worked this guy up a little bit, nice lead pass to the corner of the glass. Now you got to be patient defensively now. The Lillard's not going to be in a hurry.
Moore again. He's great in the post. Spinning. And foul.
Good strength, too. Good handle. Everybody's got to stay honest because the ability to shoot it from deep.
Nice little day then. The Blue Jays will win the regular season based on winning percentage. And, Coach, here's Villanova's resume.
Yeah, pretty impressive. Of course, winning that, winning the tournament, I think they'll improve their seed line, no question about it. Just amazing. You noted off air his Big East regular season championships, two NCAA tournaments, four Big East tourney championships. Just an amazing array of success.
Jay Wright leading the Wildcats to seven Big East regular season titles, including six crowns in the last 7 years. And those two national championships as well in 2016 and 2018.
They're going to the 2-3 zone again. Force Creighton to use some clock. This might give him an open look, at least an offensive rebound, too.
Tough shot by Jefferson as he starts to heat up.
He knows how to play this kid. Nice cut to the gut there.
And Ian Jefferson from East Chicago, Indiana. They swing it. Moore. Got it again. Justin Moore has been brilliant.
And they go side to side, guys. You got to really close out. Don't get back in your bag. Bishop only finishes that deal.
Justin Moore with 19 points. Coach Raffi, 7 for 7 from the field, 3 of 3 from the three-point line.
So efficient. 4 assists as well.
5 rebounds.
5 boards. It's a nice work. Small change on Jefferson. Workmanlike performance from the get-go.
That's all no Jay talked ones. About in the 12 seconds we talked to him yesterday.
I think he was mad at you.
Yes, he was. I don't know why, what I did.
As my mother would
say, Coach Raftery, I'm going to punish you for what I know you're going to do.
He wanted to get back to work.
Zagorowski. Great range on that shot.
Oh, you got to hug that kid. Tough matchup because he's so good with the bounce as well.
And Villanova brings the ball up the floor, and here's that slow half-court offense.
He makes you pay here. You got to be disciplined. Very hard to come from behind against the Villanova. Nice drop step.
Jefferson the other way. Inside, nicely done as Bishop, point blank range, makes the deposit. And a timeout on the floor. Coach Mack trying to figure it out, his team down.
Step out.
Look at that now.
They are
Look at that line, coach, for
pretty
Justin
impressive.
Moore. Yes.
And selfish toughness about that kid as well.
Antoine. Having some big minutes tonight off the bench. Slater on the hop. Lost it. Saved by Samuels. Shot block at six. Swider's got to do it. Step back, 20-footer. Deflected out. Swider with the loose ball and a new shot clock for Villanova.
Nice cut by Swider, too. A little miscommunication there on the step and go. Creighton can put a little run together here, Gus. Get their heads back in the game a little bit.
Still plenty of time.
Sure.
Jefferson trying to power his way over Slater and a foul. Looks like hand checking call against Slater. Pat Driscoll, lead official, right on the play.
That's a tough little entry at that elbow. Can make the jumper or use that strength, dexterity, get himself to the free throw line.
Zagorowski, nice feed. Jefferson, quick turn and bucket.
He's got to go a little bit now. Getting to the right spots. Big lift by Jefferson.
Jefferson with 13 points on 6 of 9 shooting. Makes it a 57-42 game. Man.
Kid can really rag a guy, can he? Which is tough.
Daniels deep in the hole. Lost it on the way up. Take it away. Kalkbrenner, right place, right time.
Look at defensive stance, too, man.
And Sharif Mitchell knocks down a triple.
Yeah, right back at it.
Mitchell has been ice cold the last 9 games. 3 for 16 from the floor, 0 for 7 from behind the arc. But a big shot there makes it a 57-45 game. Away. Jefferson with a hand on it. Look at
he's playing, huh?
Yes. Baseline. Samuels, no. Creighton with a chance to cut it to 10 or even lower with a 3. Here's Mitchell. Strong drive. Hand off. And a blocking foul coming up on the floor against Daniels.
Pretty good drive and find. And you know, they're all not on the floor, not as much defensive prowess that they're in. Creighton on a little bit of a run.
Blue Jays are one win shy of a program record 8th conference road win. Coach McDermott saying we haven't had many shortcomings on the road this year. Been pretty good. That's a lot coming from a coach.
Absolutely. Now they have been tough-minded. So many areas of the floor. They stretch your defense. Great shooters. Intricate sets. Good screeners. And they love that dribble handoff, too. Little baseline bumps here.
And that's out of bounds. Alex O'Connell looking for Mitchell. Miscommunication.
Yeah, pretty good D there by Villanova on the ball. They don't mind switching. Key is to take advantage of on that low box area. With little on big, particularly.
Slater. Can't get his own rebound. Under 10 to go, 57-45. A basket here will make it interesting. Ballock.
Great job getting these feet organized. He's got a little hook in his game, too.
Step back three. Ballock, no. Loose. And a foul will be called against Villanova.
Wow, I thought that was just a loose ball. Pollock's so good with his feet, getting separation for that jumper. He should really get the foul here.
Looks like Slater may have dove on top of Alex O'Connell. Biggest loss this year for Creighton, just 8 points. O'Connell step through, no. Robinson Earl with a rebound.
Well, Robinson Earl is such a factor. Guards, helps, rebounds.
Jay Rice saying he has not had a bad game defensively or on the boards this entire season.
And a pretty impressive quote from your coach.
Robinson Earl, four to shoot.
Getting into stuff early enough. A lot of stress late in the shot clock.
Jefferson puts his head down, dumps it down, and a beautifully done play. Kalkbrenner with the finish.
Boy, Dan Jefferson has just taken over this game. He'll dribble drive, draw two, find your partner. Villanova on an empty run here. Six trips, empty.
Jefferson with four assists, six rebounds to go along with his 13 points.
He is a gamer.
More gamer as well. Blocked by Kalkbrenner. They can get inside 10 right here. Baseline, O'Connell. Timely buckets. That's what Kalkbrenner's looking for.
Did a great job, Gus, keeping that ball in play off the glass.
And a foul coming up. Samuels with better position than Alex O'Connell.
Bishop doesn't hurt you to get the big fella. Kalkbrenner, nice little dive to the rim.
Agreed upon at the beginning of the season, as long as teams played at least 10 games because of COVID-19.
Chris Greg McDermott, his guys staggered in that first half. Now they seem to have their legs. And Damian Jefferson, what a force he has been getting them back in this.
57-47.
A little bit of a break there on a reach over on Jones. Pretty clean played game thus far.
Not a lot of fouls called in this game, Coach. Remember, Nova has led by as many as 22 in this game. Daniels stripped. Great hands by Zagorowski.
Absolutely. This is where they can get you in the early if you're not ready. Well, he was ready to unload.
Make that Ballack, and he'll knock down a deep triple. And just like that, Villanova's 22-point lead has been cut to 7.
Well, you've got to get up on that guy right next to his shorts.
Ballack with 9. All of his points from behind the 3-point line. Justin Moore.
Really struggling to score, coming up empty. Got to get some stuff going to the rim.
Ballack again driving this time. Cut off. Mitchell with a step on the baseline, reverse layup goes.
How about that? A little move upward the lane by Bishop, opening that up for Mitchell.
5-point game now, 6:30 to go. Creighton has climbed the mountain. And a whistle. Daniel steps on either the baseline or the sideline out of bounds.
Well, sideline. That step back that guys use for the three. All of a sudden, shaky on the offensive end, but just give him an inch. He'll take three. Beautiful looking stroke. Baseline drive finish. Use that glass. A little more spunk in his Creighton lineup right now.
57-52. The Blue Jays ranked 14th in the nation. And trailed by as many as 22 points. Zagorowski, no, rims off the rebound. And it will go to Villanova. And a foul.
I just love the way this kid rebounds. He possesses the ball. Big, strong upper body.
And that's a third foul on Antoine Jones.
It's not real efficient, but better defense also by Creighton. They got a mismatch if they want inside.
Puts it over.
Tried to help out by a switch. Such an intelligent player.
Antoine Jones to the basket, hangs in the air, off balance. 59-52.
They are comfortable late, generally, in the shot clock. So it makes them so tough. A little pressure on your D, the dribble drives.
Great defense, though, starting to stiffen up a bit. In this second half, two to shoot. Slater. Zagorowski the other way.
Got to get this kid early.
Zagorowski with 10 points tonight. Bishop kept it up high. Can't finish at the rim.
Five on four if they want.
Bishop gets back. Samuels in the corner to Moore. Sets. Ooh, beautiful rebound by Damian Jefferson.
He's doing it all. They got a clock problem again. So it's signaled by the referee.
Mm-hmm. He's got an eternity remaining in this game. 434 down, I mean up. Only 59-52 after being up by 22.
Yeah, first time a little pressure full court here with Slater. Pretty mobile kid.
Nothing about Villanova. Sorry, coach, go ahead.
Not just saying back to that zone. Looked like they were trying to screen the back.
Zagorowski, you know, one thing about Villanova, they know how to come up with timely defensive stops.
Right, they do. They had to tighten it at the right time.
Swider.
Now, most of these teams are so well coached.
Moore trying to back his man down. Ball reversal. Robinson Earl on the baseline. Samuels lost his footing. Splits the defense, can't lay it in. Jefferson with another board. Ballock deep.
When he misses, it's a surprise.
What a steal, Ballock with the lay-in.
Kid knows how to play. He really has great instincts for the game.
And the lead has been cut to five. 59-54. 3:13 to go.
Well, Swider hasn't had a clean look whatsoever. A great scouting and preparation.
Deep. Antoine. Big time jumper. Make that Slater with a big time jumper.
How about that? 8 for 16 coming in from three.
62-54. Can Creighton answer? And a foul coming up. Good hustle by Slater.
He's giving him some good minutes, Gus, and what a nice play. Oh, he's so smart.
If you weren't with us in the first half, Colin Gillespie took a spill, hurt his knee, and has not returned to the game since then.
Chris Jefferson has done a magnificent job getting his club back into it, showing a lot of emotion.
Zagorowski had to work for everything today. Long rebound, and Robinson Earl with it, and Villanova will be in no hurry.
Absolutely. Pull the plug. They slowly put you into your misery, don't they?
Yes, they do, and it's painful.
Yeah. Now you need the ball. Sometimes jump a lane and pay for it.
Moore crossed over. And one. Wow, Justin Moore with Colin Gillespie on the bench has really taken over this game, and he is dominating.
Well, they really have guys who don't mind stepping up, taking advantage, good handle. Talked about his strength all game and try to wall up. A little small bang, and this is the spirit that epitomizes this program.
Justin Moore, 21 points on 8 of 11 shooting. He's 3 for 5 from the three-point line. 5 rebounds, 5 assists, and a block.
Trying to get your quick hitters going now. Looks like that little zone match again.
Zagorowski turns the corner, comes up way short. Robinson Earl with another rebound.
Oh, I thought he got banged on that shot.
Robinson Earl with 12 rebounds, all defensive rebounds tonight.
Well, he does this a lot. Bring it up, handling it well. There's so many nice things for this club. He is their center, but he really is, in my mind, a small forward who can play power forward. Very versatile player.
Listed at 6'9". 2019-20 Big East Freshman of the Year. He averaged 11 points and 10 rebounds a game. 65-54, the lead growing now with 1:35 to go at Villanova. Mitchell. Jefferson, tough rebound inside and a foul.
The kid's giving it all, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Nice performance by him.
13 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists.
Now, one thing about the good shooting teams, you have opportunities around that glass with those soft deliveries. Make this get you press ready a little bit. See if you can create some problems. Slater gets his third foul on that rebound.
He missed them both. Robinson Earl with his 13th board, and he can bring the ball up the floor. Look at him at 6'9". Tough pass there.
He just deflected and just kept going.
And a timeout called by Nova with 1:12 to go. We'll step away. Back right after this.
Wow. Well, they really told him not to put any weight on it, you know? Mm-hmm. He's acting like there's nothing wrong. I wouldn't bet against this kid.
I wouldn't bet against him at all.
Approved.
Mm-hmm. Swider, the inbounder. Slater tightropes the baseline, tries to create space, gets his own rebound, and they'll get it back out and run some clock. 58 seconds to play. Swider wide open and pure.
That's what he's all about. Can't give him any space or distance.
68-54. Creighton has gone cold. Babak. That's another triple.
Good. Is he tough? Quick reaction on the release. A gamer.
Where they say
culinary, it's still flowing.
45.3 remaining. 68-57. Creighton picks up full court.
Got to run through the ball. No trouble getting it in. They've been very lucky at a couple of these.
Robinson Earl fouled. He's a 78% free throw shooter.
Yes, Swider at 6'10" can see over everything, but you've got to cut, present yourself. Big responsibility taking it out.
Robinson Earl struggled in the first Creighton game, 8 points on 3 of 13 shooting. He's got 12, make it 13 now. To go along with 14 rebounds.
I'm sorry, Gus, if Villanova goes on to win this, which it looks like they will, it's just attributable to that first half defensive scheme that This guy in the funny-looking clothes. We're used to those suits, right?
He's still GQJ to me, Coach.
Mm-hmm. But he had great preparation. Didn't get hurt by that fast pace over the timeline, Jay.
70-57, 40 seconds left. Villanova with a great game plan coming into this game. He told you, Jay Wright, the only thing he wanted to talk to us in the 8 seconds that he talked to us was defense, and his defense has come out and played extremely well.
Well, you were personally insulted.
No, don't say that.
I took it as a compliment that he only gave us a couple of minutes.
You stayed on the phone, Coach. You want to talk serious basketball, coach to coach.
He was worried about Denzel's versatility, Jefferson's contributions, and we all know about the perimeter guys where they can stick it. Bishop, to me, is the key for this team. His activity, his screening, his slipping, those are the things that you're so accustomed to.
And an easy one for Justin Moore. Moore will finish with a spectacular performance. Right now, 22 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists. Make that 24 points. Rebound going to Samuels, and he'll walk it over the midcourt line. Villanova improving their record to 16-4, 11-3 in the Big East. They get their revenge on Creighton, but more importantly, they clinch the regular season Big East title and will be the number one seed next week in the Big East tournament at the world's most famous arena. 72-60, the final. Nova defeats Creighton.
Great respect with these kids for one another and these coaches. Be fun in New York, guys. Bring your